everybody. Just you have a wonderful time with your family today. As we observe the day of Christ's birth today, let us be thankful for what God has done in our lives. Amen. I just like to open the service up. Father, we thank you. Lord God, that we go to see another Christmas. We thank you, Father God, as a church. Lord, that you have carried us. Father God, I thank you for the service today. I ask you, Lord, that you move amongst us today, Father God. Lord, that your word become real to each and every one of us. Father God, Lord, as the service progresses, Father God, we pray for the flow of your anointing in this place. For your angels to move in this place, Father God. Lord, let everything that is done here today, Father God, be as what you desire and what you have ordained, Father God, for this name, Jesus. God for giving us good health. Amen. We want to thank you for the strength he's given us in our bodies throughout the year 2023. We want to thank him that he's kept diseases away. He has kept sickness away from our bodies. I want you to turn with me to Exodus 15 verse 26. Exodus 15 verse 26. Says, and said, if you will diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God, and do what is right in his sight, and give ear to his commandments, and keep all his statutes, I will put none of his diseases upon you, on which I have brought into the Egyptians, for I am the Lord, I heal you. Amen. So he's the Lord who heals us. He's the one who healed us and healed your family. So today we're coming back to say thank you, Lord, for the healing that we've experienced as a church and as a people. We are thanking God for providing for all of us through this year. You ate and you enjoyed because God has blessed you. Amen. God has provided. And so today, on the day we commemorate the birth of Christ, and we say thank you to God for the healing power that we experience in our lives and in our families. Amen. So I want you to join me as we thank God for healing. We thank him for blessing. We thank him to keep it, for keeping sickness out of our bodies. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come as a church, we come and say thank you, Father God. Lord, that this year, Father God, that we have not experienced lack. We have not experience, Father God, sickness and diseases in our bodies, because you have come and you have healed us. You have come and you have carried us, Father God. Lord, you are our provider. You are our Jehovah Jireh, Father God. Lord, you are Jehovah Rapha, our healer, Father God. Lord, that is why your name is Jehovah Rapha, because you are the one that heals, Father God. I thank you, Lord, that everyone in this church, Father God, has not experienced disease, because you placed a special hedge around each and every one of us. So Father God, today we come and we say thank you. We come and we say thank you. We give glory and honor to you for healing our bodies, for making us strong, Father. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that we lack no good thing, because this year you have provided. You have shown us your hand, Father God. And today we come and we say thank you. We glory and we honor you, Lord. We say thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness and your mercy towards each and every one of us. We honor you for that, Lord. And we thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Our next prayer point. We want to thank God for granting us a pastor like Pastor Sam. Amen. The shepherd of this house. He teaches us the word and the ways of the Lord. Amen. We have seen growth. We have experienced spiritual maturity since being in this house. Amen. He has equipped us through this past year. So today we want to thank God for our pastor that we have. And in Jeremiah 3 verse 15, house, where we are taught the word, we are given the unfiltered word of God, and we are taught and we are equipped to face whatever onslaught the enemy might bring our way. And that is because God has anointed a man and placed him in this house who will be subject unto him. So today I want you to thank God for this ministry. I want you to thank God for the shepherd of this house, the man of God of this house, and ask God to bless him. Amen. So join me as we thank God for the impact we're ministering. Father God, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for this house that you have granted unto us, Father God. Lord, where we can come and be fed the word. We thank you, Father God, for the men that you place the shepherd over this house, Father, who teaches us the word, who shows us how to rightly divide the scriptures, Father. Lord, who's equipped us, Father God, for this life. Who's equipped us, Father God, to become mighty men and women of God. Father God, we thank you for that anointing that you've placed on the inside of me, Father God. Lord, and we know that that anointing flows to each and every one of us in this house who subjects us here, Father God. Lord, we thank you. Father God, we ask that you bless it, Father God, exceedingly abundantly, Father. Lord, for laboring. Father God, Lord, that you honor him for that, Father God. As we honor you today, Father, we thank you that we have a house in which we can come and worship you, in which we can come, Father God, and learn of you, Father Lord, in which we can come and divide scripture, Father. Lord, we thank you for impact word ministries. We ask that you bless it. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Our next prayer point. We are going to ask God for the Holy Spirit to become real. Amen? To become very real in order for us to hear His voice directly at all times. Amen? John 14, 16 to 17. John 14, 16 to 17 says the following. are asking, God, that when His word is coming, that the Holy Ghost will fall on the people in this place, that you will be filled with the Holy Spirit and speak in new tongues, if you haven't already. So we're asking God to pour His anointing on our pastor as He brings us the word today. We are also asking God for His anointing to come upon each and every one of us, so that we can experience and see tangible miracles take place in this house, even as we are ministering and as we are being ministered to. So we're going to ask God for an infilling of His Holy Spirit to come on the word that is about to come today. Amen. So I want you to turn with me in your Bibles to Acts 10 verse 44. Acts 10 verse 44. Acts 10 verse 44 says the following. It says, while Peter was still speaking these words, the Holy Spirit fell upon all those who heard the word. Amen. It said there, you go down, it says, and those of the circumcised who believed were astonished, as many that came with Peter, because of the gift of the Holy Spirit being poured out on the Gentiles also. For they heard them speaking with tongues, magnifying God. Peter answered, can anyone forbid water to those who are not baptized, who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have? And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. And then they asked him to stay along for a few days. So we are going to ask God. Amen. We're going to ask God for His Holy Spirit. That when the word is coming today, for His Holy Spirit to fall upon this place. Amen. To fall these people. And to heal those people. We are going to ask God for that infilling of the Holy Ghost, that fresh infilling of the Holy Ghost to come upon each and every one of us this morning. Amen. So join me as we pray and we ask God for that. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come before you as a church and we ask, Father God, Lord, to give us a fresh infilling of your Holy Spirit today, Father God. Lord, even as we go into praise and worship, Father God, that you fill us, Lord, for your people today in the service. Lord, even as the word is coming, I pray, Father God, for healings to take place. I pray, Lord, for signs, wonders, and miracles to be experienced by your people under the sound of the voice, Father God. Under the sound of our voice, Lord. Even as we are praising and worshiping, Father God, Lord, your word says, ask and it shall be given. So, Father God, today we ask, Lord, for those who do not cannot pray in tongues, Father God. We pray, we ask you, Father God, to give them the gift of tongues. Lord, let us experience the gift of miracles. Let us experience the gifts of healing, Father God. Lord, those gifts that you tell us about, that the apostles walked in, Father God. Lord, you said each and every one of us is able to walk in them, Father. Lord, that the evidence and word is coming to them, Father God. Lord, let that word minister healing and life to our bodies. Let that word minister, Father God. Lord, grace towards us, Father. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Our last prayer point. We are going to ask God to make His word real in our hearts. Amen. As you read the word today in the service, and as you read the word at home on your own individually, and as you hear, listen to teachings that comes from this house, that God will make His Spirit real to you.
Amen.
Amen. Even today in the service, the Lord is going to speak to each and every one of you.
Amen.
So right now we're going to pray. And we're going to ask God to grant us that our ears be opened to hear what He has to say to us. of the new covenant, not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter kills, but the Spirit gives life. Amen? God's Spirit gives life. So just reading letters will kill you, but the Spirit will cause breath to go into you. Amen? The breath of the Word of God will come alive on the inside of you. Amen? The Word can appear dull, but our prayers should be to receive a quickening of that Word as we read it. Even as we hear the Word that is coming today, when we listen to teachings, we are going to ask God to make that real, to make that Word breathe life into our spirits. Amen? So I want you to join me as we pray and ask God to make His Word be life in our spirits. Amen? Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we pray for the Word that's coming today. Father God, we pray that each time we open up the Scriptures, Father God, each time we listen to teachings as a church and as individuals, Father God, Lord, we pray for the breath of Your life to come onto the inside of our spirits, Father God. Lord, Your Word says the Word, the letter kills, but the Spirit brings life. So Father God, today we ask for Your life to breathe on the inside of us, Father God, as the Word is coming. Lord, as we are reading, as our eyes are resting on the Word, Father God, Lord, we pray for life to come into our spirits, Father God. Lord, give us a fresh infilling of life in our spirits today, in the name of Jesus. Amen. I want you to turn with me to 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 18.
We thank you, Lord. you, Lord, that everyone will come back with a testimony of how you have done the work, of how you have provided, how you have healed, how you have set free, Father. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord.
Are you blessed to be in the house of the Lord this morning?
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Are you ready to praise God?
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We're ready to go to praise and worship.
Amen.
My soul shall make a boast in the Lord.
Shall make a note in the Lord.
Lord, you are beautiful. Thank you.
Amen.